31-31 series continues. Today we're talking about the Montreal Canadiens. Dan Rosen here, EJ Hradek there. They tried to solve their problems with one fell swoop, didn't they?
Yes,
Montreal
they
Canadiens gave the offer sheet on July 1st to Sebastian Aho, 83 points in 82 games last season with the Carolina Hurricanes. A center. They need center depth. Power play was brutal last year for the Canadiens. 30th in the league. Aho would make it better. 5-year, $42.27 million offer sheet, loaded with the money in the first year. And it took about 2 minutes for the Carolina Hurricanes to say, we're going to match this. So Montreal did not solve their problems, did not get the number one center. So do they still have the same issues that have plagued them now? They missed the playoffs last year, 3 out of the last 4 years too.
Well, they were close last year.
They were close.
They were
in for a long time.
Yeah, they were right there till the end, and then Columbus was able to sneak ahead of them there and get that final playoff spot. They had the right idea with Sebastian Aho in terms of a player that would have been a great fit for their team. It really would have been a great fit.
They needed to go higher.
Exactly. The execution of the offer sheet was not great in my view. Apparently within their group, there must have been a feeling that the Carolina Hurricanes ownership group was leveraged financially or wasn't liquid enough to match that kind of offer sheet that was designed with those with all that money front end.
You know what billionaires have?
Money.
They have money.
I have money, but I'm just saying that's the only thing I could think of in terms of why they went in that direction. Because if you're the Hurricanes, you know, not only, you know, the fact that, okay, are we going to match or not match, but if you didn't match, you lose the player, and you get, because of the compensation level, you got a first-round pick, a second-round pick, and a third-round pick. You wouldn't trade, let's say, and if Montreal were to have Aho, let's say they figure in the top third of the league, you're basically trading, what, the 20th, 70th, and 95th pick to get Aho. Nobody would make that trade. So in the end, I thought the idea was accurate, but I thought the execution on Montreal's part was really, they didn't do all their homework in my view, and they didn't get the players. So they are back to square one. They are still weak through the middle of their team. I think they are kind of moving in the right direction. I like some of their younger players there, but you know, still, they need help in the middle.
They need help in the middle. Philip Dano, Max Domi, Jesperi Kotkaniemi, Nate Thompson. That looks like their center depth at this point. I mean, that can change. Yeah. We know how that changed. Kotkaniemi is the interesting one to me. You know, he was a rookie last year. He had a strong first half. I mean, he kind of figured out his way. If he can improve, I mean, they drafted him, what was he, the number three pick in the draft a couple years ago? So they drafted him to be their future number one center. They drafted him to be their Sebastian Aho, right? And maybe he takes the next step to being that this season.
Yeah, I mean, they've got to hope for that. They've got to hope some of the other younger players they have within their system could step in and really provide some help for
Ryan them. Pulling
there you
gets a hat trick a game.
Yeah, well, he's got one game.
He's got one game and he got a hat trick and a shootout winner.
And a shootout winner. So, I mean, but, you know, there's a great example. Maybe he can come in and be a helpful player for them. Obviously, he's not going to score at that level over the course of 82 games. But if he can come in and be a player for them, that's a big plus as well. They've got Carey Price when he's healthy in goal. Terrific supporting him this year with Keith Kincaid. They brought him in as a free agent. And, you know, you're looking at playing Keith maybe 20 games. And so, you know, if Carey Price stays healthy, that certainly helps the Montreal Canadiens. They've got Shea Weber healthy for the full season. They didn't have him last year for the full season. He came in like December. And, you know, he's a presence certainly for that team. Victor Mete is somebody that you have to keep an eye on there because he's a puck-moving left-shot defenseman. If you put him with Weber and it works, that could be a really nice pair. They added Ben Chiarot. I think a really good signing for Marc Bergevin to add a player like that. I think the contract, the terms, and the dollars were good. And Chiarot has got some size and can play in a lot of different situations and can move around your lineup a little bit on the back end. So I like that. But again, a lot of it is going to fall to how well they defend and how well Carey Price plays.
Well, absolutely. But I think we can expect Carey Price to be Carey Price. Yeah. I mean, that's got to be the expectation. And if you look at their D to me is fine, especially if Weber is healthy. It's the center depth, as we talked about. But also, it's a guy like Jonathan Drouin. Jonathan Drouin had 18 goals last season in 81 games.
He's not a center.
He's not a center. We know that.
Remember, they got him. They're going to try to play him at center. I mean, it was obvious he wasn't a center. I didn't really understand why they tried to do that.
Drouin's got to be a 30-goal guy.
He needs to produce more.
You know, look, their power play, as I mentioned, and dragged them down. May have been the reason that they did not make the playoffs last season because they were close and it dragged them down. They were 13.2% on the power play last season. Drouin should help that power play. Yeah. It should be better with him and Brendan Gallagher and Max Domi and Tomas Tatar and Shea Weber. That's the difference right there. Their power play bumps up 5, 6%, 7%. Maybe they are a playoff team.
Yeah, they would have been in last year if they had had that
this
kind
season,
of improvement.
You know,
we'll see if they can do it this year. it will be an interesting year for the Canadiens. There's always high expectations in Montreal for their team. But the failure to go out and make that big move and to get Aho, I mean, to make that contract offer. And the offer sheets, it seems like they rarely work. But if you're going to do it right. I don't think they gave themselves the best opportunity to get the player based on what they offered.
There'll be a summit in the provincial government if the Canadiens miss the playoffs for the third year in the fourth year in the past five. I just don't know, you know, with their center. So I look at it right now and I look at the division. Look, Tampa Bay is still really good.
Yeah.
Boston's still really good. Toronto's really good.
And Florida's
better. I don't know that Montreal can finish in the top four. I don't know that there's only going to be three teams in the Metro this year that go after sending five last season because a number of those teams also improved.
Very logical deduction on your part.
So I'm saying no on the playoffs. Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah, I'm in the same boat as we sit now, unless there's any other acquisitions that take place between now and the start of the season and what they can do during the year. I like their group. I think they'll be competitive, but in the end, I think it'll be like last year. They'll fall a couple points short.